TikTok is now suing the U.S. government, with NBC News reporting that TikTok filed a lawsuit this morning in the U.S. Court of Appeals for the D.C. Circuit, and in that, arguing that the Protecting Americans from Foreign Adversary-Controlled Applications Act, right, the one meant to make the Chinese owners sell the app or have it banned, that it violates constitutional protections of free speech. With TikTok claiming in the lawsuit, for the first time in history, Congress has enacted a law that subjects a single named speech platform to a permanent nationwide ban, and bars every American from participating in a unique online community with more than 1 billion people worldwide. Now, as far as what this means for you, right, if you're someone that uses TikTok, the really big thing is that this changes the timeline. Right, because of this bill that was signed by Biden, ByteDance, which owns TikTok, they essentially had a year to figure things out. But by jumping into this lawsuit, no matter how it ends, at the very least, it extends the timeline probably years. That is a lot of time for creators to diversify where you post stuff and where your audiences exist. Kind of like how the majority of people watch my show on YouTube, but I pushed to PhillyD.TV and Spotify and Apple Podcasts. And again, that is separate from how the lawsuit itself will actually end. Right? Because as outlets like Axios have noted, TikTok says the government hasn't met the burden of proof required around its claims around the app's risk to data security. With the lawsuit reading, Congress itself has offered nothing to suggest that the TikTok platform poses the types of risks to data security or the spread of foreign propaganda that could conceivably justify the act. Right? Saying that at most, they have offered speculation, not evidence. But, you know, all of this is playing out as you have people like reportedly an associate clinical professor of law at Cornell University and an associate director of its First Amendment clinic saying TikTok has prevailed in its previous First Amendment challenges. But the bipartisan nature of this federal law may make judges more likely to defer to a congressional determination that the company poses a national security risk. But also adding, without public discussion of what exactly the risks are, however, it's difficult to determine why the court should validate such an unprecedented law. Right? And so the road is now laid in front of TikTok and the U.S. government, and it's going to be interesting to watch it play out.